Shawn, walk me through the trade deadline just happened. So I was fascinated by, you know, when they pull players off, you hear about them pulling players off the ice. You know, this person didn't dress at this game because they might get traded. They get traded halfway through a game. Walk me through the process of that anarchy that goes through being traded to a team. You got to go, you know, you got to jump on a plane. You got to go. You're on your new team, like within 12 hours and you're on the ice, and how that team takes care of you. I know a couple guys in operations that kind of help with that, but I'd like to hear it from a player perspective.
Yeah, I was traded twice actually in my career at the deadline. So I was traded from Florida, where I was there for 6 years, to Vancouver at the deadline. And I was just on the bus, and then I saw Luongo tweet out a palm tree, and then my brother was calling me. I could hear all the guys whispering in the back, but they hadn't announced. I guess everyone just assumed it was me. And then including my brother, who was calling me going, "Are you coming?" He lived in Vancouver, so he was all pumped. He was hoping it was me. And then I got to the rink, and then they informed me. And then as soon as they inform you, they basically hand you your gear, and you just wait on instructions. Like, they're done with you, basically, right? You're not their property anymore. So I literally went with my gear, and I was only on a one-game road trip. So I only had a backpack full of, like, just, like, sleeping clothes and, like, my toothbrush, basically. And I was wearing my suit. And then I was just waiting under the grandstands for 2.5 periods. Finally, I got, like, told. They got me a hotel room. They figured out my flight. And the next morning, I was off to Dallas, and I played that night for the Vancouver Canucks. And then, And then the next time was, after that, I went to Vancouver, and I had no clothes or anything. So you can't get any further from Vancouver to Florida, right? So my girlfriend, my now wife, she was a rock star. She actually packed up a bunch of bags and was there like 3 days later just to help me out. So it's if you don't have someone in your life, you're a single guy, it can be really hard, because it happens real quick. And like I said, once the team's done with you, I mean, you're somebody else's property. So it's their problem now, right?
That's fascinating. And then, at least they didn't kick you off the bus like they did the coach, remember? Didn't Florida has a habit of doing that, didn't they?
The historian cab.
It must be anarchy. I mean, I didn't realize that you just take a travel bag overnight.
Yeah, well, the second time I got treated at home, which was nice. So I was out with a concussion for 2 weeks. And then they brought me back in the lineup. They're like, "You're playing tonight." I was like, "I haven't even practiced." So I played that night, and it was my birthday. So I was like, "I'm going out with all my friends." And then the next morning, I get a call from Lou, and I'm like, Lou Lamorello at like Sunset Grill with all my friends, and we're still like hungover, and we're like, "Oh man, what did we do last night?" And "You've been traded to from the Leafs and all this," and he starts talking. I'm like, "Lou, just tell me where I went." And he's like, "Colorado." I'm like, "Okay, that's not too bad." But then you got to wait for visas and stuff, right? So I stayed in Toronto for like another 4 days. So that was actually kind of nice. I got like a 4-day break, like mid-season that year. So it was kind of cool.
Thanks for stopping by, friends, to the Brenton on Tour podcast channel on YouTube. Coffee, music, travel, life, all of those things. One page, lots of guests, lots of chatter. We talk about all of it. If you like it, subscribe, hit the thumbs up button, leave a comment. I'll get back to you. Thanks, friends. See you next time.